So this first one is a very old poem. It's one of my first poems that I ever written. It's a spoken word piece, and it's called Talking to Myself. Enjoy. My depression is as small as the tide, warming in and out on a beach, and then suddenly a tsunami which obliterates every inch of my being without warning, and I silently drown until those waves disperse and let me finally breathe. Those days are dark, and each one leaves its own mark. It is ever changing like the earth beneath my feet, and I walk this earth like a ghost, a shadow of my former. I force myself to go out and about because inside me there is a black hole which threatens to consume me, an emptiness which I cannot escape. My mom tells me to go out to see your friends. Yes, I try to make plans. I try to make plans, but I don't want to. And oftentimes I don't follow through. You see, I'm trapped in my mind, in my room, held at ransom. But the price is just so high. Anxiety holds me hostage. When I do see my friends, I try to have fun, but having fun is just no fun. When deep down you don't want to have fun, when deep down you just want to cry. You see, insomnia has this way of making the glittering night sky perfect and all the stars my friends. And it holds me sure and tight and to no end. Still, everyone tells me to count sheep, but my mind can only count the reasons to stay awake as I am weary. My mom tells me to put makeup on, but putting cake on my face is as useless as lighting a match in the rain. It's like trying to bring back the dead because I am near too. I am not afraid of dying. I am afraid of living. Afraid of the next new day, the next sunrise, because somehow I have managed to focus all my energies into this lonely way of living. The thoughts that run through my head more often than any is that death would be more forgiving. And still, my depression drags me back to that place that I am perpetuously running from, and it turns my legs to stone and my words to the constant blubber as I cry. Because I am tired of running, tired of living. Thank you. The second poem is a brand new creation by myself. And I actually finished it tonight. It's one of those things that you keep putting off, and you're just like, I'll get around to it. I'll finish it. It'll be all right. It'll be great. But it never happens. So this is another very serious poem. Let's see if you can decipher the meaning. It's quite plain and simple because that's how I do things. But this is called Temple. I respect my body. I only ask that you do it too. But instead you trample it and violate its ground. You do as you please and it pleases you as you do. Destroying the shrine and my soul with it. Laughing and disregarding. So help me let my heart split. Invading this space, turning me into an object without any objections, categorizing my body as a thing, objectifying me with your abject intentions. No sexual abstentions to seal me in prevention from your perversities, because there are no niceties in this game of formalities. Being tossed and turned, used like a plaything, hidden away thing, a toy used day-to-day thing. Or just vomits and ruined. Defiled and desecrated, where little remains and little in the way of living, because there is no forgiving. The destruction left in your wake, the life that you take, what you make of beauty and turn it into your actions, made me break. My heart, my soul, my mind, my happiness is fake. Because you stripped me of the one thing I kept guarded. My body is a temple, but you destroyed it.